Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 3, Episode 3, The Smell of Salted Fish.
Gua adalah anak pertama dari 5 bersaudara, lahir dan besar di Pematang Siantar, Sumatera Utara. Dari kecil, gua sudah diajarkan untuk bekerja, menjaga toko, mengantar kue ke pasar untuk dijual, dan sepulang sekolah, gua kembali ke pasar untuk menerima uang dari hasil penjualan kue. Di saat teman-teman sebaya gua pulang sekolah, bisa bermain, gua harus menjaga toko sampai sore. Dan itu dilakukan setiap hari, dari hari Senin sampai Minggu. Walaupun gua suka kesal, tapi gua menjalani tugas yang diberikan oleh orang tua kepada gua. Gua juga sudah terbiasa dengan wangi khas dari ikan asin yang memenuhi seisi toko dan lantai atas rumah. Kebetulan kami sekeluarga tinggal di atas toko. Tidak jarang baju gua terimbas wangi khas ikan asin dan gua sudah terbiasa apabila ada teman-teman di sekolah suka tanya. Bahkan dengan nada mengejek gua, "Kok baju gua berasa wangi ikan asin?" Bertahun-tahun gua memendam rasa malu karena wangi ikan asin yang melekat di baju. Sampai akhirnya gua bisa menerima dan bersahabat dengan wangi khas tersebut. Pak Landung dan Nyonya Ai, kedua orang tua gua, rupanya tahu hal ini. Dan selalu bilang sama gua dan adik gua untuk tidak boleh malu menjadi anak penjual ikan asin. Harus bangga karena dari hasil jual ikan asin dan 9 bahan pokok inilah yang bisa membiayai sekolah dan kuliah gua beserta adik-adik gua. Kedua orang tua gua juga mendidik anak-anaknya untuk menjadi petarung sekaligus pejuang kehidupan. Bau ikan asin yang menempel dan tidak bisa gue tutupin tanpa gue sadari merupakan salah satu pendidikan awal bahwa sekeras apapun hidup tidak boleh lari dan bersembunyi. Harus dihadapin karena itulah sekolah kehidupan yang sesungguhnya. Gue melanjutkan kuliah dan menetap di Jakarta. Menjadi warga Jakarta adalah cita-cita dari kecil. Bekerja di industri hiburan adalah mimpi yang terus gue pelihara. Gua pupuk dan gua bawa dalam doa gua setiap harinya. Jakarta mendidik gua menjadi sosok yang mandiri, tahan banting, tidak mudah patah semangat apalagi mengeluh. Jakarta juga memberikan tempat kepada gua untuk meraih mimpi-mimpi gua, salah satunya menjadi manajer artis. Semua itu tidak ada yang gampang, tidak ada yang instan, tidak ada yang serta-merta langsung kejadian. Gue yang memulai karir gue dari posisi yang paling bawah sebagai runner. Dari sana perlahan-lahan merangkak naik. Begitu banyak jalan terjal yang harus dilalui, jatuh bangun yang sudah tidak terhitung jumlahnya. Tahap demi tahap gue lalui dengan kesabaran, terkadang hanya ditemani oleh air mata, sepi dan seorang diri. Bekerja, jatuh, bangun, jatuh lagi dan bangun lagi, begitulah seterusnya. Itulah kehidupan yang gue lakoni. Gua nikmati dan gua resapin. Sampai kapanpun, gua akan terus menjadi murid dari kehidupan. Tidak ada secuil penyesalan berkarir di industri hiburan dan memilih artis manajer sebagai profesi. Menjadi manajer artis adalah sebuah kebanggaan. Pekerjaan terhormat yang akan gua kenang sepanjang hidup gua. Perjalanan masih sangat panjang. Gua sendiri tidak tahu hingga kapan yang pasti. Selagi masih diberi nafas dan semangat, gua akan terus berjalan, berlari, melompat tinggi, kadang berhenti sejenak, bersiap untuk melangkah lagi. Memilih menjadi pejuang kehidupan adalah kebanggaan yang patut dirayakan.
The next one will be the English version of the story. Sulung is the eldest of 5 siblings. He was born and raised in Pematang Siantar, North Sumatra. Since he was little, he was already taught to work, minding the store, delivering cakes to the market to be sold, and returning to the market after school to pick up the money from the sales of the cakes.
While Solong's friends played after school, he had to mind the store until the afternoon, and that was done every day from Monday to Sunday. Although annoyed, he still did the chores that were assigned to him by his parents. Solong was also accustomed with the unique smell coming from the salted fish that filled the store and the floor above it. His family lived above the store. Often enough, his clothes also absorbed the smell of that salted fish, and he got used to being asked by his school friends, who made fun of him because of that salted fish smell from his clothing. For years, he had to endure the embarrassment of the smell of salted fish on his clothes, until he eventually could accept and made peace with that specific smell. Mr. Lan Dung and Mrs. Ai apparently knew about this and had always taught Solong and his younger siblings to never be embarrassed about being children of a salted fish seller. They must be proud of that fact, as the income from selling salted fish and other main food ingredients was what paid for their education till university. Both Solong's parents also taught their children to be tough and work hard in life. That smell of salted fish that stuck and could not be covered unknowingly was one of the early teachings that no matter how hard life gets, one should never run and hide. Those challenges must be faced, as those are the real lessons in life. Solong continued his university education and resided in Jakarta. Being a citizen of Jakarta was his childhood goal. Working in the entertainment industry had been a dream that he nurtured, worked for, and prayed for every day. Jakarta made him into an independent person who is tough, not easily discouraged, and never complained. Jakarta provided a place for him to realize his dreams, one of them being a manager for artists. All of that was not easy. Nothing was ever achieved instantly or just happened by itself. Solong started his career from the bottom as a runner and slowly worked his way up. Many steep paths had to be passed with uncountable failings and getting ups. Step by step, he had to go through them all, alone, with patience, and sometimes only accompanied by his solitary tears. Solong went through the cycle of work, fail, get up again. That is his life, in which he lived through, enjoyed, and endured. Until forever, he will always be a student of life. He never once regretted his career choice, working in the entertainment industry as an artist manager. Solong is proud, working as an artist manager, an honorable profession, which he knows he will carry with him for the rest of his life. The journey ahead is still long. Solong himself does not know until when. One thing is for sure, while he is still breathing and passionate, he will keep on walking, running, and jumping. Sometimes stopping for a while to get ready and start again. Choosing to become a life fighter is something to be proud of and worthy of a celebration. This is a story from Solong Lan Dung, who is originally from Pamatang Siantar, North Sumatra. He currently lives and works in Jakarta as a manager for artists, establishing the company Avatara 88 or Avatara 88 Artist Management. He also has written two books on artist management and will launch his third book this year. He has also been involved in movie productions as assistant producer and co-producer, musical dramas, and became one of the hosts of a podcast called Di Belakang Layar, or Behind the Scenes. As this is one of our editions, as we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we can all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn that how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us.
I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast.
and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes. These are our stories. What is yours?